EA Sports. It's in the game.
I'm doing it wrong, and please stop me.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. Next, you're going to select from one of three. Next, pretty explanatory. We'll move on. Hey, everybody, Brandon Gauden back for another year of action with Madden NFL 19. Let's take a look at what's new this year. Real Player Motion makes its Madden debut, bringing unmatched responsiveness and fluidity to every player on the field. In the running game, hit the hole and one cut give ball carriers the ability to move through crowded running lanes and turn on the jets once they see a sliver of daylight. Once you reach the end zone, it's time to celebrate either alone or with your closest friends. Long Shot returns for its second season, picking up the story of Devin Wade and Colt Cruz as they continue to chase their NFL dreams. In franchise mode, new ski. So there you go. Nothing to it. Charles Davis and myself will be with you along the way, but from all of us at EA Sports, get out there and enjoy Madden NFL 19.
Okay, I'm back to school, you. This is open campus. This is, I should slap it open-handed. Tough life, I told a model she need lower standards. Asked her if she had a twin, I feel like Joey Tanner. Big spender, Kris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, it's happening. Think she called me, cause she never knew her daddy. And my dog black, Rhythm Nation, Janet, boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, was underground. Frontin' like a ride with the mob, why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll, holler them all. Strutting like Pac out the court, hop out the Porsche, shake that, got that on menu, the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave, watch for the sharks bounce. Sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was ganging since the Platinum FUBU days. Dreams of being Hova, action movie, yay. Listen, babe, listen so good, you'll think I'm cool with yay.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. Welcome to the special Saturday edition of the NFL.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New York Giants and the San Francisco 49ers.
Here we go. We got three.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. Garrett Celek, the tight end, was the target. That'll bring up second down.
Personally, I think they've got to go somewhere else with the football. They've got to bracket it out there in double coverage. Makes it hard to fit it in time after time.
It would have had to have been an absolutely perfect pass and not good enough. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He lost two there, and it's third down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before lost yardage.
Terrific read. Better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Now a play fake here on first down. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Well, it's just been an aerial attack all the way downfield, and they're putting it to the defense in a big way right now. What do you think, partner? Do you now run the football? Because they're in a pretty good spot already, the outer edges of the field goal.
But like you always tell me, you're still far enough away from the end zone that a pass could be a good option here, too.
You know, we always talk about running the ball until people take it away from you. I don't see any reason to stop throwing it until they take it away from you as well.
Well, the early returns here on the opening drive, though, solid.
Back to the air on second. It's Garoppolo, and that's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, lest my eyes deceive me, I think they found a matchup that they're trying to exploit here, don't you? I guess the second time they've gone to him here on this drive.
Yeah, opening drive. It's a tone setter, right? I think they're going to be looking his way. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Garrett Salick from 8 yards out. And the 49ers drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails? Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Gold with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. Here's Khalif Raymond to return. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Manning and the Giants come up now first and 10 at their own 24. Now the first running back drafted this year, it's Saquon Barkley. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
On play action, now Manning, and down he goes. The 49ers get there. DeForest Buckner breaking through to get him for a loss of 7.
Tremendous read and reaction by the defensive tackle, and frankly, partner, it's not that often the DTs have that type of easy access back to the quarterback. Never bought the play action fake.
He finds Beckham complete. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. A good pickup there, a 22.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I like what they tried to do there. They didn't get a completed pass downfield, but they came off of a momentum play. Big time gain on the previous snap. Came right back and threw one deep, hoping to catch him on their heels.
And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Working from the gun, Manning, and Ingram hauls it in. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 41. They go play action here on first down. Throw left side, complete to Ingram. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now, prior to the snap, we hit all zeros as time has run out on the first quarter of play. 7-0 is our score. We're back to Santa Clara after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's the Giants with the football here as we begin quarter number 2. They've got a second down and 5 here to start things out. Second down, here's Barkley. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The tackle by Eric Armstead. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Already a pair of third down conversions for them on this drive, but right now they need 5 yards on this third down try. From the gun, it's Manning. And that is incomplete.
And that's a crusher right there. Had his man open for a first down, threw a fastball when that wasn't necessary, incomplete pass. When are these quarterbacks going to learn? You don't get extra points for how hard you throw the football.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice, that it all came together. But I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
So the long field goal misses, and now the reverse. You're in a tough spot defensively. They'll start the drive at the 43. Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
Delay of game, offense.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the
still
numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run. and just lost track, and it cost him.
Garoppolo now. And bringing it in, this is Salek over the middle. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? 3-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Garoppolo going to try and throw on 3rd. And this is going to be incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up 4th. But he will be stopped behind the line as he will not come close to the marker. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Giants are going to get the football back. Well, you feel the excitement build on those 4th down plays. Defense has to stay out there, but for the offense, when that thing doesn't work out, such disappointment.
It can absolutely be a deflator, but how about the defensive guys? If they stop you on 4th down, they are absolutely elevated going to their bench.
They're elevated now. Big stop on 4th down. Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
And you remember pre-draft, there's a lot of speculation that the Giants should look for their future quarterback at number 2 with a great possibility. Remember, Sam Darnold from USC was still on the board, but they passed on him to take this runner, Saquon Barkley. And this is exactly why. They think he can extend the life of Eli Manning's career and give them 1,000-yard seasons year after year.
They haven't had a 1,000-yard season since 2012. Ahmad Bradshaw did it then. Manning gonna throw. Incomplete. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position you have to be, you just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 5, and that leaves him with 5 more. 3rd and 5 now.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
They'll set up the screen to Barkley, and he's going to have the 1st down yardage to the 35. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. A 1st down carry for Barkley. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. Clock rolling as the Giants will hurry to the line. To throw is Manning. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Evan Engram was the intended target, and it's third and short.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. What a spin. Now another. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. First down, Garoppolo. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
To throw is Garoppolo. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
So after the INT, it's Manning. Get this out to Barkley, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets them a new set of downs. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Manning again here on second and 10. And this is caught at the 8. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. First trip to the red zone for the Giants. They've got a first and goal to go at the 7. Again, they'll throw with Manning. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, when someone other than the quarterback is throwing the football, it's either beautiful or a disaster, and here it was the latter.
Nowhere in between, right? I think you're exactly right. It takes a fortitude to call that type of a play.
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. Touchdown, 49ers. Jimmy Garoppolo with his second touchdown pass of this first half. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for 6. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 14-0. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game.
And on his first carry, he loses the football.
Knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front as we send you cross country to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there. We now proceed to the start of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Second down, here's Manning. Over the middle, he's got his tight end, Ingram. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Manning now just 7 of 15 so far, but he's got a 1st and 10. On 1st and 10, here's Manning toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know? He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Now he'll let it go. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense: find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. That is caught at the 7. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play.
Looking for Garcon, he's got him. Touchdown, 49ers. Three touchdown passes now for Jimmy Garoppolo. And the 49ers add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Now Garoppolo and the Niners will come up and go for two. Snap comes at one. Garoppolo. This will be caught at about the six. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five.
An unsuccessful attempt at the two-point conversion. And it was a triple option play. And they chose option one, handing it to the fullback. And that's not normal.
And sometimes you just miss your read key, right?
Yeah, I think so. And sometimes they actually call that, thinking that maybe everyone will bypass the fullback going out to the tailback or the quarterback. But in this case, they overwhelmed him and stopped him.
And the 49ers defense gets ready here as they trot back out there.
And now Big Mo's wearing a shirt of their color. They're hoping to continue that momentum in their direction, but maybe another pick.
Who's Big Mo? He's momentum, right?
Momentum. And right now, he's hugging them.
Over the middle to Beckham. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now Manning, and complete to Lewis over the middle. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And it's going to be third down and a ways to go here, 3rd and 14. Now Manning again. It's caught, Shepard. And oh, he coughed it up. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them. Big tackle, knock the ball free. Anything you can do to slow them down.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Got the guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
He got 29 yards that time. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, back now here in Santa Clara. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. And Gold is able to put it through. And that will up the score now. It's 23-0. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. Raymond now on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And he can't hang on. He had a good shot there for his third pick of the game. Instead, it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Manning now to throw, and that's complete to Lewis. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Way forward to the 48. Malcolm Smith there for the stop.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Manning the throw on second down. And this is incomplete. He was looking for Evan Engram, the tight end. And it's third down.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. Throwing is Manning on third down. And this time he's got the pickup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make...
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the former Super Bowl MVP, Malcolm Smith. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They are excited about where they are in this game.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle, that evens things out, especially for a road team, especially for a team that's an underdog.
Now a shot taken on 3rd down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
4th quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Good starting field position for the New York Giants here as they come up 1st and 10. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. It's been that kind of a day so far throwing the football. It just seems like nothing going right offensively.
Yeah, it's a catch that should have been made, pure and simple. And look, everything else that goes into running a good pass route, throw it all out if you don't catch the ball.
Been that kind of game throwing the football so far. Nothing going right offensively. Manning able to find OBJ there for a Giants 1st down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Lewis. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
And that's one of his advantages of a passer, isn't that? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Again, it's Manning, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Here's Manning to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
You got a young quarterback. You know, maybe that's just an example of a growing pain for him.
I think you're right about that, because when the game starts to move fast and it moves quickly on him, a lot of times they fall back on what they know best, their arm. He's slinging it on this one.
And he takes it into the end zone for a Giant TD. Jonathan Stewart taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Giants are able to draw a bit closer.
So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no 0. Are you, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle.
And the 49er hands team does its job.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door.
We did indeed. I think we're down to 9.
The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts
And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Garoppolo looking to throw. Complete to the tight end Kittle over the middle of the field. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as it comes with a minute 25 left to go in the contest.
Here we go.
Garoppolo on first down. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run with McKinnon. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. The ball still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. So that's one you almost never see at this level, a wobbler from very short range, and it winds up no good.
All right, Brandon, if he slipped or someone got a hand on it, then I can understand it, but it's almost like you heard a whistle or something to stop this swing. A very strange result, especially for an NFL kicker.
And that one incomplete as it stops the clock, reading 18 seconds to go. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that play was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call, mark off the five, and keep it moving.
Throwing now is Manning. He's going to let it fly. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Now a desperation throw deep down. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Charles, when playing, it's a fun game.